Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right, he said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. There are some, if you remember in the 25th chapter of Matthew, there were five wise virgins.
Yes.
And there were five foolish virgins. And the foolish virgins slept.
Yes.
They were asleep when Jesus came. Now, let me tell you something. Not everybody is going to be asleep.
No, they're not.
In this day, in this hour that we're living in. There are a lot of people sleeping that are sitting in church houses today and have not had their eyes open to truth. Can you say amen? They're asleep. They're asleep to Jesus Christ.
That's right.
They're not alive in Jesus Christ. But then he goes on to say, and he's talking now about those that are awake. And he said to them, but we shall all be changed.
Yes.
Now look what he's saying right here. In a moment. Do you know that when the Word of God comes forth?
Yes, Lord.
Because I've got to just kind of let me lay the foundation here of what we're talking about. The moment is a revelation.
Yes, it is.
The twinkling of an eye is when your spiritual eye opens.
Amen.
And do you know what? When you get a revelation from God, it comes just like that.
Yes, it
comes suddenly.
Amen.
Suddenly. Just like the Holy Ghost fell on the day of Pentecost.
Amen.
Suddenly.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Suddenly.
Yes.
I receive a revelation from God. My eyes are open. I start to see something.
Bless your name.
In the twinkling of an eye.
Yes.
At the last trump. You know what the last trump is? It's the message for present day truth to be given. That's a trumpet that's being sounded right over this pulpit right now. The last day trumpet is coming forth. That's the message.
Yes.
It's a message.
Yes.
A trumpet is a message. The sound of the trumpet in Israel when the temple. When they were coming together, they were about to leave. They packed up the temple. There was a sound of a trumpet that caused a group to come out. And that went to the west. There was a group, there's another sound. And every movement that was made in regard to that temple was distinguished by a certain sound that was all given through that trumpet player. Now here today, there's a ministry that's holding up a trumpet, and the trumpet is not a literal trumpet, but it's the Word of God. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Word of God is being sounded. It's time for the temple to move in another direction. How many can feel the presence of God moving us right here in the day that we're living in? Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. You know, let's finish reading the verses, because I don't want to have to go back and read. I'm ready to preach. For this corruptible must put on incorruption. This mortal must put on immortality. So, and listen, he's showing a difference right here. He's showing that nature has to change and your spiritual temple has to change. That is, that we're going to receive another house, not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. We're going to get that. Mm-hmm. And we're going to receive a new nature.
Yes.
A new spirit.
Yes,
a new nature.
Yes,
let me tell you something. What you're fighting with has got to stop.
Yes,
you can't fight flesh with flesh.
No, you can't.
You need the Spirit of the Holy Ghost to take charge of your life.
Amen.
And let the power of the Holy Ghost fight your battles. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
by the power of the Holy Ghost.
You
have power through the Holy Ghost.
Yes, you do.
The Holy Ghost is not just an experience at the altar.
No, it's not.
The Holy Ghost is the very life of God that enters into your being. If you allow that to draw strength from heaven, you will be able to fight anything in your nature and in your life. You can do all you want to. You can get psychologists. You can get group meetings. But until the Holy Ghost is alive in your spirit, you cannot be a conqueror. You will not put on immortality. You will not keep fighting the corruption of this age. You'll still be a corruptible individual in the end. But I'm talking about something that the Word of God has called a mystery, but it's an open up for us here today that we can be conquerors through Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The strength of the Holy Spirit of God.
Yes. Woo! Faith. Yes. Faith.
Praise Him with me. Something that's real.
Praise God.
Are you getting the drift of what I'm saying?
Yes. Amen.
So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, this mortal shall have put on immortality. See, there's a change of your nature and also your physical. There's a transition that takes place.
Yes.
Then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord.
Oh, death.
Oh, Jesus.
Where is thy sting, O grave? Where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin. That means that what causes your death is sin.
Yes.
But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Now, Paul made a positive gesture there in his statements. But look what he says in the 58th verse. He said, therefore, my beloved brethren, be you steadfast. You know what steadfast means?
No.
Be steady.
Yes.
Be stable.
Yes. Amen.
Stand.
Amen.
Then he said, be an unmovable.
Amen.
Nothing can move me.
Amen. No way.
Nothing
Amen.
Will move me.
No.
I'm telling you something. You can have that in your life. I can have that in my life.
Yes.
If I allow the very process to take place that he previously laid out before us,
yes.
That we must put on an incorruptible spirit.
Yes.
That we have to put down the corruptible nature that's dwelling in us through the power. You know, man could not do it.
No.
He could not overcome.
No.
He said the law was weak because of what? The flesh. The law showed sin. It showed that the wrath of God would come on those that would sin. That is set in existence. It exists today. But thank God, through Jesus Christ dying on the cross, that gave us the accessibility, but Him living a righteous life here on this earth, and He conquered His nature, never gave over. We have the blueprint right before us that we can. Jesus said, fear not, for I have overcome the world. You can overcome the world. I can overcome the world through Christ. Through Christ. Everyone say that with me. Through Christ. Say it again. Repeat it with me. Through Christ. Through Christ. Through Christ. Through Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody said, don't get so excited, preacher. I can't help but get excited about what God is doing for us in this hour, in this day that we're living in.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Somebody said something about old age today. You know what? I refuse. Mm-hmm. I refuse it.
Yes.
I'm not going to claim it. I'm going to claim I'm just as young as I am.
Amen.
Because you know why? I've got eternity ahead of me. Blessed be the name of the Lord. This body might be failing and coming apart at the seams, but oh, praise God, if I put on immortality and I put on incorruptible, I am going to have a house, praise God, not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Always abounding.
Always. Yes, Lord.
Come on.
Always.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. I want to give you definitions that I have here. All right?
Okay.
Are you ready for this?
Uh-huh.
The word steadfast means to be firm, fixed, determined, purposed,
amen,
faithful, and fixed in his belief and labor for the Lord, determined to live for the Lord and to carry out his purpose for the Lord.
Amen.
The believer is to be faithful to the end.
Yes.
No matter what comes, no matter what rises. Let me tell you something. If there's a statement of quitting come into my spirit, there's something wrong with my relationship with
the Lord. Amen, yes. Amen.
I'm telling you now.
That's true.
I'm making some boldacious statements, but it's a fact. Because my focus is on the fence post.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
What Paul was trying to tell them, mm-hmm. You've got to get off the fence post.
Yes, amen. Mm-hmm. Yes,
you've got to make a determination that living for Jesus Christ is all that matters in your life.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, you'll be tempted. Yes, you'll be tried.
Yes, you will.
You have to be tempted.
Yes,
you have to be tried.
Yes.
Because your old man has to die.
Amen.
It has to suffer that affliction.
Yes.
But do you know what? While you're going through the affliction, your natural body, or rather your natural makeup, will tell you you can't do it.
That's right.
But if you are with Christ, there's a spiritual person inside of you that says you already have overcome the world. Blessed be the Lord.
Bless your name.
We've got to get to that point, Satan God.
Yes, we do. Amen. Yes, we do.
You think it's bad now?
It's going to get worse.
It's getting worse.
Yes, it is.
Yes, it is.
Oh, yeah.
People are leaving the church.
Yes, they are.
There's no interaction in the church.
Mm-mm.
There's no new movement in the church. And you know why? Because we're living in the final sounding of the last trump.
That's right.
And God is going to have those that will be steadfast.
Yes.
Let's look at the definition on unmovable. Means to be unyielding, unshaken, undisturbed. The believer is not to be fickle in his service for the Lord.
Yes.
He is to stand as solid as a rock in his beliefs and his serving of the Lord.
Yes.
Now, if we have trouble with that, we have trouble with that.
Yes.
Then let's pray for a revival because people have done away with revivals, but I still believe in revivals.
Yes, amen.
Maybe not calling in an out-of-town evangelist, but why couldn't the gift of the evangelist rise up right here in the assembly?
That's right. That's right.
Where the gift of the evangelist can be working and reaching those. After all, if I have to send for an evangelist out of town, he's not going to know the hearts of this group.
No, he's not.
He's not going to have a feeling for the hearts of the group. He doesn't know where the troubles lie.
No, he
doesn't have any concept of where to go. And most generally, they have a rehearsed message that continuously from place to place, they'll preach the same message. But I'm here to tell you that if there is a doubt in your spirit, enough of God is in this place. If you do not have the Holy Ghost, and if you haven't had the evidence of speaking in other tongues, then you don't have the Holy Ghost.
No, you don't.
You have the Holy Spirit dwelling with you.
Yes.
But praise God, the Holy Ghost has to be in you.
Yes.
It has to be a gift from God.
Yes.
Not just what dwells with you.
Right.
The Holy Ghost dwelled with, the Lord put the Holy Ghost on prophets in the Old Testament. He put the Holy Ghost on the priests. He put the Holy Ghost on the craftsmen.
Yes.
He put the Holy Ghost on those that were doing the ministry of the temple. He put the Holy Ghost on those men. He put the Holy Ghost on warriors. He put the Holy Ghost on those that fought great battles in the Old Testament.
Amen.
But it was not a gift.
No.
It was an anointing that touched their heart. And the Holy Ghost was with them. But here I'm telling you here today that the Holy Ghost can dwell in you. And it can be a gift from God to you. Blessed be the Lord. And through the baptism of the Holy Ghost,
bless your name, Lord Jesus.
You can be an overcomer.
Amen.
You can deny your flesh.
Hallelujah.
You can overcome. The believer, now let's look at the word, I guess, abound. The believer is to abound in the work of the Lord. There are two significant points in the word abound. The word labor means toiling and working to the point of exhaustion and fatigue to the point of collapse. The word always means never cease, never stop, never slacken up, never quit, never retire. Somebody asked if I was going to retire from the ministry. I said, how do you do that? The believer will be rewarded. What a challenge for the believer. This is the reward that he's going to give. And he notices where he said, for you know. Mm-hmm. Now let me tell you something. You have to have a relationship with the Lord to be in this position.
Yes, you do.
You have to have an acquaintance with God.
Yes, you do.
You cannot have God as an abstract somewhere.
Amen.
There has to be a relationship.
Bless your name.
If without a relationship, you're not going to feel what Paul was trying to say right here. He said, and I'll read the whole verse. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be you steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Catch it?
Yes.
Your labor in the Lord. Now you can labor to be a good person. You can labor to be a good moral person. You can labor. You can be a good business person. You can be a good worker for a firm or a place of business, for a nursing home, for any type of business that you might be in. You might be a good person. You might have a good moral standard. You might have a good life. But let me tell you something. You have got to become a spiritual person. You have got to become a new creature in Christ Jesus. You have got to become not a fleshly or a fleshly being or a person that has a carnal personality. In other words, you've got to get out of that fleshly realm, because whatever you do in the flesh will not last. But what you do for Christ, it's eternal. So what if I labor and I labor for the Lord, if I labor in the Lord, it will not be in vain. What I do for the Lord will have results. Did you hear that?
Not recognition, results.
Yes.
It'll be eternal results.
Amen.
Not temporary.
Amen.
I can give Jerry a $20 bill. I didn't say I was going to.
Good.
Or I could give Jerry a $100 bill.
Yes.
I couldn't. But do you know what?
I'd be gone.
That won't last.
No.
It's a good gesture.
Yes.
Brother Jerry would love it.
Yes.
He'd say, oh man, that's pastor of mine. I just love him.
Yes, oh man.
But you know what? That's temporary.
Yes, temporary.
Amen.
Yes, it
is.
That's not eternal.
That's right.
Are you getting the drift of what I'm saying?
Yes.
Amen.
Because you can live a good moral life.
Yes.
But it's still, if it's done with your carnal makeup. Did you get that?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
It's temporary.
Yes, it is.
All the good that you do, it's temporary.
Jesus. God is in control.
But if God initiates the action.
Yes, and he did.
I would rather give Brother Jerry something that will bring eternal life to his soul.
Amen.
Then I'm working in Christ Jesus.
Such as I have.
Amen. Yes.
Such as I have. Yes.
I give unto you.
Amen.
That's what Jesus said.
Yeah. Praise the Lord.
He said, I don't. Who was that said that? No, I forgot.
That's fine.
He said, I don't have.
Yes.
Oh, no,
yes.
Here it is. That's the third chapter of the book of Acts. Peter and John went to the gate called Beautiful. Remember that?
Yes.
He went to the gate called Beautiful.
Yes.
And there was a blind man there, and he was begging for alms.
That's right.
Alms.
Alms.
That's money.
Yes.
He was begging for money. And just like some people are on the street corner with signs saying, can you give me a dollar? I'm out of work. That's what that man was doing. He was crippled from his mother's womb. 38 years, he was an invalid. But Peter said, silver and gold have I none. Have we none, he said.
Yes.
John was there, wasn't he?
Yes, that's right.
And he said, silver and gold have we none. But that which we give, that's which we have.
Yes, amen.
He said, take my hand. Rise up.
Yes.
And walk.
And walk.
Yes.
But do you know what?
Rain.
That wasn't the greatest thing that they did for that man.
No.
Because that man later followed their ministry.
Yes.
Yes.
And he gave the hand.
Half of the righteous. Yes.
Let me tell you something. God's got a hand in the earth right now.
Yes, he does.
Yes, he does.
And that hand is called the ministry. And right now, the ministry is telling you right now, take my right hand, rise up, and walk in Christ Jesus right now.
Right now.
Right now. That's a mystery. It's a mystery. Can you feel what I'm feeling right now? God's giving you a revelation of that mystery right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yes, your name.
left hand.
Yes.
The Bible has the right hand.
Yes.
Yes. Elijah went out 7 times.
Yes.
Perfect number. 7.
Yes.
And when he looked up in the sky, he saw a cloud, a little cloud. Lichen, not the size of a man's hand, but lichen unto a man's hand.
Yes.
Yes. Been wonderful if he had an icon, wouldn't you think?
Oh, yes. Oh, absolutely.
But he had that, he saw that hand.
Amen.
And the abundance of rain came out of that
yes.
hand.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, we've addressed that as being the spirit. But do you know what that rain is?
Oh, yes.
That is the word of God.
Amen.
Becoming a revelation.
Yes, Lord.
Through the power of the Holy Ghost. Blessed be the Lord. And, oh, God, I feel the Holy Ghost all over me.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
I don't know if Elijah fully understood what it meant.
Jesus.
But I can tell you what.
Yes.
The servant, that is, the servant.
Yeah, the servant.
He went back to Elijah.
Yeah. Amen.
He said, I saw a man's hand.
Yes.
And I saw the abundance of rain in those clouds.
Yeah.
And there's a rain coming. And let me tell you something, saints of God, I feel that in the spirit.
Yes.
There's a ministry that's going to rise up
yes.
and do it the right way.
Yes.
Not their personality, not their abilities, but by the Holy Ghost of God, there's a right hand that's rising up. Now, at the end of the 1,000 years, there's a left hand that's going to judge this world. But right now, God has got a right hand to bring saints of God together to the truth. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Which hand do you want to be a part of? The right hand or the left hand? Hallelujah. I want to fall subject to the Holy Spirit. Blessed be the Lord. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost is here. Reach up and touch him right now. Is here. His power is here. His gift is here. Hallelujah. My God. I'm going to tell you something. You're really going to have to want this to get it.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are.
You texting me something?
Yes, you are.
You really have to want that. Is that your Bible? Is that there?
Praise God.
Bless your name.
Praise God.
The Lord's here.
Yes,
yes,
He is. Yes, He is.
The Lord's here.
Yes, He is.
Are you going to go through the doubt? Are you going to leave the doubt behind? Are you going to start becoming steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord?
Yes.
Instead of holding back, instead of letting the devil defeat you, when are you going to get rid of that selfish spirit and quit nurturing that spirit? Get rid of that spirit, because that's a selfish spirit.
That's right.
Blessed be the Lord. If you ever make a study of the book of John, the first book of John, it talks about the lust of the flesh and the pride of life and the lust of the eye. All three of those things, or the three of those works, all build up self.
Bless your name.
Everything is pointing to build up self. That's where Adam got in trouble. You read the second chapter of the book of Genesis, and you'll find that the pride of life got Adam, the lust of the flesh got Adam, and the lust of the eye got Adam. And he led mankind into oblivion and into death. But here come another man, his name was Jesus, and he came 2,000 years ago, and he walked the same pathway that Adam walked, but he overcame on the mount. He overcame the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And you and I have got an opportunity through the power of the Holy Ghost to do the same thing. Overcome the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, and the pride of life. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
My cardiologist
would say, you should be out of breath right now.
Yes, he would.
He doesn't know what he's talking about.
Praise God.
When the Spirit of God gets a hold of you,
he will come.
It doesn't matter if your heart's pumping the quarter.
That's right. Or you have one.
God's going to let you tell the church what needs to be told. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What a tremendous message from God this is.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Yes.
I don't want you to tell me I preached a great message.
No.
Because the pride of life might slip in.
That's right.
So don't do that.
No,
we don't have to.
God.
And don't.
God was good.
And don't.
God did. Amen.
Yes.
Don't tell me how good I look.
Don't worry, I won't.
Honey, you do.
Don't tell me.
Sorry.
Not the way you're on.
The pride of my life.
Because we don't need to hear that kind of stuff.
No, we don't.
We're overcomers.
Yes, we are.
Yes, Lord.
God is bringing his church to a level.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
That Sebring has never experienced.
Amen.
I mean, can say amen.
Yes. Amen.
It took us all these years to get rid of the baggage that men put on our plates. I appreciate what I heard in the past. But right now, I don't need to hear about the 144,000 again. I need to hear what it takes to let Christ rule and reign in my life and help me to overcome my nature in my flesh.
Yes. Holy Jesus.
Some people serve God because they're scared to death of going to hell and burning forever.
Yes.
Burning eternally.
Yes.
You know, forever has an end.
Yes, it does. That's right, forever it does.
Yes, it does.
But you can lay in a grave eternally.
Yeah, you can.
And even then you can't. Because your body starts to be eat up with
God
insects.
Bless them, Lord. Yes.
Bless them, Lord.
Yes.
Bless you, Sister Cindy. Bless you, Brother Rico.
Yes.
God go with you. Sister Cindy has to go to work.
And I know she has.
And I'm glad she stayed to the very last minute she could.
Yes, amen.
But I'm glad.
Yes.
Because your body and my body will go to a grave.
Yes, amen.
And the bugs will get worms. You know, you got worms in you already.
Yes, we do.
You do?
Yeah. Parasites.
And they'll come and I don't care what kind of tomb they put you in.
Uh-huh.
They're going to get you.
Yes, they are.
Or what they
involve
you
with. And now even, a lot of people go for cremation now. Somebody asked me, is that really a sin, isn't it? Well, I don't believe so. Death is dead.
Death is
exactly.
Death.
What you do with your body.
That's right.
If you do have a cremation because you think that God's going to help you better if you're cremated, then you're in ideology, you're idols.
That's right.
What is that? Oh, the cloud. Yes, seven times. But I'm glad. And you know what seven means in the Bible? Seven is God's
perfect
number.
Yes.
And you know what that means? That in God's time, certain things and events happen. And let me tell you something. We're living in a certain time when the last trump is going to be sounded.
Yes. Amen.
All right, I appreciate the Lord. And
amen.
You know, I got tons more to say, but I want to have your attention when I say it. But God's been good to us, hasn't he?
Yes.
Can I say something?
Sure.
I was sitting the other morning in my chair having a coffee, and my chin itched. My hand just went right up and started scratching my chin, and the Lord said, the hand takes care of the whole body.
Amen.
Amen. No matter what part it is, and when it reaches my foot don't say, don't bother me.
No.
No, it doesn't.
The hand you talked about.
The ministry.
Well, take care of it.
Amen.
The whole body.
body. It's yes, it does.
Yes, it will.
Now look, the hand has the thumb and these other four fingers.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Now if you take the apostle,
yes.
That's the thumb.
Yes.
Now if you take your fingers, I can do this with that finger,
yep.
With that finger. I can do it with this finger.
Yes.
I can do it with this finger. I can do it with this finger.
Yep.
The apostle works with all the gifts.
Yes.
But now an evangelist, he has a hard time to get these other fingers working because the pinky is the evangelist. But the point is this, that God has a fivefold ministry. That's gifts. Those are gifts. And today, I don't know which gift was working, but I appreciate God using me. Because Brother Jerry needed to hear this message.
Yes.
All of you needed to hear this message. Because this is where we're at today. So I appreciate the power of the Lord, and I appreciate the Holy Spirit being here. And incidentally, if you want to receive the Holy Ghost, come back next week.
Yes.
Next Friday night.
Yes.
And we'll pray. Now, the sisters are meeting when?
Wednesday.
Wednesday
at 6 o'clock at Rebecca's.
At Rebecca's house. Now, brethren, hello, brethren. Are we missing some brethren? Yeah, we are. Not this week, but the week after, we're going to have a meeting. And we're going to pray, God help us as he's helping the sisters. How many brethren will appreciate that? We're going to get together, and we're going to set it on the calendar. I don't know when you're going to meet because you guys are sporadic in your meetings now. You're either Wednesday, Tuesday, or Saturday. So you'll have to tell me because I want to meet at the same time.
It's generally Wednesdays at 6 o'clock.
At 6 o'clock. But
now, we did two. One was because we wanted to include Sister Cindy, and then next one was because of Thanksgiving.
All right.
And Saturdays is because we want to include Sister Lottie.
Yeah.
All right. But what I'm saying, though, is this is what I'm. What my thinking is that one of these new sisters that's coming to the meetings, and I told Sister Tammy and Sister Marcia that they need to be plugged in to the church.
Right.
There, it's a group from the church, because it's an outreach.
Yes, amen.
Is it not? It's an outreach.
It is.
It's not just sisters coming together and. And gaining knowledge and gaining strength and gaining fellowship, but we also need to have but we also need to have an outreach for the Lord. So I don't know, one of these ladies might have a boyfriend or a husband that would come to a men's meeting if we held it at the same time. That's what something to consider, because there are some that are considering making this assembly their home.
Yes.
And let me tell you, battles we have fought through the years, I'm seeing some daylight. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Don't
amen.
Yeah. Are you
going to
do it the same location or just the same night?
No, just the same night.
Okay.
No, we'll probably just meet here at the church.
Okay.
The brethren will meet here. Because of the distance of Brother Rico and some of the others, we're trying to centralize. But it'll be, if are you going to have a meeting a week from this coming Wednesday? Is it going to be on a Wednesday?
Most probably, unless something comes up to where somebody says nay, or nay.
Right, that needs to be. Okay, that needs to be written in stone because we need to know all that. We need to have that. Somebody said, don't plan anything because God can do it.
No.
No,
we do.
No,
stay
God.
Fast. Stay fast.
You know, that's just like saying, okay, we're not going to have church next Sunday if, unless somebody comes. I mean, you know, unless we feel like it.
Unless we feel like it.
You know, that's, or God tells us to. Or, you know, you know, God expects us to have order, doesn't he?
Yes, he does.
There has to be order. So, 2 weeks then, or rather a week from this coming Wednesday, brethren, we're meeting here at 6 o'clock. All right? Now, brother, Stacy's husband?
Brian.
I'm just pushing you, brother. But brother Brian, you might have to make it possible or take an hour or so away early to get here.
Yes.
But you don't know where you're going to be that then, but you need to be here.
Yes.
You know, we have reached for help outside of this assembly. Let's turn it around.
Yes.
Amen.
Let's bring this in place.
Yes.
You know, I long for the day when we can take and rehabilitate druggies.
Yes.
Excuse me. I don't like that term anymore.
No.
But drug addicts, alcohol, people who have alcohol. People that have problems with overeating,
yes.
Not eating right.
Such as we have give to them.
Any addiction.
Any addiction.
Mm-hmm.
You believe God can help us to do that?
He can.
We can help people.
He can.
And in turn, when they're getting help,
so are we.
Their soul help? Is being helped.
Amen.
Such as we have.
And we can have rehab.
Yes.
Let me believe that.
Amen.
We can do that.
Yes, Lord. Yes.
I know I'm in very close contact with the Loving Hands Ministries.
Yes.
That
yes.
Portion of it was here 2 weeks ago, and I'm going to call Wendell and tell him to bring the group from Palmetto over as well. They were a blessing to me. I know my son is there with them, and of course that. But you know what? I believe God has a purpose for everything.
Amen.
Yes.
I am now not a person that is so judgmental. Because addiction makes you do all kinds of things to feed that addiction. It makes you lie, makes you cheat, makes you steal, makes you sacrifice. And you know the sad part about it is, the victims are those family members that are close.
Yes,
by.
Yes, that's true.
The ones they love.
That's
the ones
very
they love.
True.
The ones that hurt.
So let's pray that God will give us a good, strong church.
Yes, amen.
We don't need 1,000 people. We can do it with this group right here.
Amen.
We got Brother Jerry. He's over there in West Palm Beach.
Yes.
If he'll stir the ground over there, and he gets a few people that want to be in a church service, guess what? We'll load up cars and go over there and have a meeting with him.
Yes. Yes, Lord.
Can't we do that?
Mm-hmm.
And there could be a door open for us right there.
Yes.
All right.
Well.
They're on Wednesday night now. They're. I know it's a women's meeting, but that little kid is going to be there again. That is, his family was Catholic, and he doesn't like the church that Rebecca's going to. And
well,
put him on my heart. So
well,
he,
then we can try. You try to direct him to the men's meeting.
Right, right.
That would be the thing to do.
Yes, it may be good if you came, Pastor. It may be good if you came.
If who came?
You did.
But dear, I'm going to be in a men's meeting that day.
Not this week. I thought you said it was the week after.
It's this Wednesday. He's going to be
there. Oh, this Wednesday he's going to be there. Well, I guess I'll have to be there.
That'll be the groundwork for the following week.
Okay, where are we going to have it?
At Rebecca's house.
Well, then Brother Howard and Brother Stacy. Brother Brian. Let's try to make that meeting.
Amen.
And let's try to be in their meeting.
Yes. Listen.
Brother Howard, that's your daughter.
Yes. Amen.
And there's a possibility that the Lord could cut them loose. And he is dealing with them. That's the problem. Is he dealing with Rebecca's sisters?
Yes.
Now, Brother Howard.
God, amen.
With that girl.
He is.
So the Lord can bring her in and help her. So, and I'll tell you what we need to pray for Sister Judy. That's Sister Tammy's mother.
Yes.
She was with us at one point.
Yes.
And I'm not going to go into that. That's not important. No. But let's pray for her.
Yes.
Because she has a soul.
Yes, she does.
And she has a lot of truth in her heart.
Yes, she does.
And so let's pray to God.
Following you.
Open her heart, open her mind. I tell you what, and I'm saying this in a positive, Zonia, if you're listening and watching this, but God changed Zonia.
Amen. Yes, he did.
And turned her around. She loves this assembly.
Yes, she does.
Yes, amen.
And if she moves to Florida, you know where she's going to be? Right
yes,
here.
She will.
And God will bless her. So, God's been good to us. We do need to receive the offering, lest we forget, and maybe sing a song. And at closing, Brother Jerry, will you pass the basket for me, please? And receive the offering. Just wait until they dig out. I believe they already have, so let's up the offering sound because we need it. This is the day.
This is the hour.
Garage sale of Brother Brian. However, if we can work through the week this week or next week, we need to work here. And that way it's not pressure on us next week before the garage sale.
Oh, that's right.
Garage sale. So if we can even devote a couple hours, a few days a week, it's going to make a big difference when it comes time to actually have the garage sale, to organize it and get it ready.
Yes.
What dining room set up?
And we have the dining room set up. Now, we can utilize those tables.
Yes, but we will break it back down.
Break it back down.
We'll have dinner on Sunday.
Because we're having dinner Sunday.
So we will really need the young people who can help that afternoon after the yard sale.
That's right.
Okay, another thing is the...
She's talking to you, Caitlin.
I am talking to you, Caitlin. You and your people have to spread the word.
Don't forget, man. You know what? I didn't say anything.